Welcome back. Today we're going to talk about the method of separating differential equations to solve them. This is from section 2.1, Separable Method. Now, this method is very simple, and you've maybe seen it in your calculus class already. So let me go through the procedure to remind you a little bit, and then let's talk about the theory and how it actually gets a little bit complicated. So first, the procedure is to check that you can separate the equation, which means that you write it in slope form, where the slope form is the derivative equal to a function of the two variables. Now, if you can separate that function of the two variables into two functions, one of each variable, then you know that you can separate it. How? Well, you just bring the x's onto one side. Here we divide by that h of x function, and then bring the t's on the other. Here we multiply by dt. Now, this is where it gets interesting, because you can see the dx, you can see the dt, and you want to. It's really quite intuitive to simply integrate. You separate and you integrate. But this form is actually a shorthand for a u substitution. We technically can't break a derivative apart into its two components, dx and dt, like this. But it's the same as a u substitution. Let me show you. So if you leave the whole derivative on one side and simply multiply both sides by dt, a small amount of change in time, and then integrate both sides with respect to that time, which is the technical way you integrate on both sides, then you have a function, a derivative of x, and a dt that you're integrating over. You use a u substitution where u equals x on the bottom. Then your du, differential, is the derivative of that x term, so dx dt, times the t differential. So you take that whole section and replace it with du. And we get the integral of 1 over h of u times du. Well, since we used u equals x, we could flip back a little bit and just replace that variable with x, and we have the integral of 1 over h of x times dx equal to the integral of gt times dt. And that's exactly what we do in the method of separating the variables. Okay, so now you know that you can separate them out. Technically, you're doing a shortcut, but it does work. And then you integrate and solve for x. Now, I say you do that if possible, because sometimes when you integrate, you cannot solve for 1x by itself. You end up with an implicit solution. But most of the time, you can solve for it explicitly by solving for x. Now, let's check to see which of these equations, our differential equations, our method works for. Because, unfortunately, you'll see in differential equations, a lot of these methods are tailored towards specific types of differential equations, specific patterns. So let's check. First, we have x prime equals x squared plus x plus 3. Okay, so first off, x prime is the same thing as dx dt. So we got the slope form already written out. We want to write the right-hand side of the slope as a function of t times a function of x. And I don't see a function of t here, but a constant like 1 can be a function of t. So I can simply write this as dx dt equals 1. That's my function of t times x squared plus x plus 3. Check. That is separable. And you would separate it by moving that chunk on the bottom, multiplying dt on the other side, and integrating through. Now the next one, e. We have x prime minus x equals cosine of t. Now this is a dangerous equation because it looks like it's separated, but it's not written in slope form. So let's first write in slope form. X prime will be dx dt, and we'll add x to the other side, x plus, might as well do it in the other order, cosine of t plus x. We want to get it as a function of t times a function of x. No. That sum of a function of t plus a function of x does not allow us to factor it as a product. So, that is not separable. It cannot be solved using the method of separation of variables. It can still be solved. We'll see later. But it cannot be solved with this method. Now, the last one. We have it in slope form. X prime equals this sum of terms. I'm going to look on the right-hand side. Can we separate that? Well, there's lots of terms. So let's see. Given x, t squared. Okay, so if we just look at the first two terms, those are separable. Yeah, we can factor a t squared out and get an x plus 1. But then we have these other terms, and they don't have a t squared in them. So it gets complicated. Well, let's attempt to separate it. We have that t squared we factored out of the first two. And then we have a minus tx minus t. Now, we can separate that sum into a minus t times x plus 1. And now we look again. Now we have two things added together. Can we separate those? Can we factor the t's away from the x's? Well, yes, because they both have a common term of x plus 1. So we factor that common x plus 1 out, and we're left with t squared here and a minus t there. Check. That one is separable. So don't give up too soon. Make sure you write it in slope form, like in the case of this one, and keep trying to see if you can pull it apart to factor it into a function of t and a function of x. Next up, we'll try some examples to solve with this separable method.